Okay, this sermon is entitled The True Narrow Road. I'd like to open up with prayer, and then with a few verses. All right, dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners. I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Psalm 26 reads, Judge me, O Lord, for I have walked in mine integrity. I have trusted also in the Lord. Therefore I shall not slide. Examine me, O Lord, and prove me. Try my reins in my heart, for thy loving kindness is before mine eyes, and I have walked in thy truth. Turn over to Matthew chapter 7. Let's take a look at verses 13 and 14, and it reads, Enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way, which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. Now, according to the world, this narrow gate, or this narrow road, consists of obedience. You have to live a life of isolation, seclusion, or insularity, when in reality, it's just referring to Jesus Christ as being the narrow road, because he's the only one that saves. Turn over to Luke chapter 13. We have a parallel passage to this. It reads in verse 24, Strive to enter in at the straight gate, for many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in, and shall not be able. Now, the reason why people are not going to be able to get to heaven is because they're trusting in their works. They have too much baggage. They can't enter the narrow gate. And that's what the broad path is. It's just works. I've got a list of different things that people are trusting in. And the reason we know it's broad is because there's only one way to heaven. But all these other paths, all these other things are going to keep a person from being saved. Number one, religion, sacraments, legalism, baptism, obedience, repenting of sins. Anything a person's trying to do in their flesh is going to lead them down the broad path to hell. So let's take a look at some verses that make it very clear that Jesus Christ is the only way. Turn over to John chapter 14. The narrow way just simply means that there's only one way. We see this in verse 6. Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Now notice he says, I am the way. He didn't say, I'm one of the ways. See, the broad path has many ways, but none of them actually work. Now turn over to John chapter 10, and we see this concept again. It reads in verse 9, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. So the only way to heaven, the real narrow path, despite what religion says, is to trust Jesus Christ alone. He is the door. He is the only way. And once you trust him, you're saved forever, eternally secure. And that's the narrow path. So watch out for all these false prophets that want to keep you on the broad path that leads to hell. That's all I have. Let me go ahead and close in prayer. Dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners. I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.